السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، فإن الأيام تمضي والساعات، وتسير الشهور والسنوات، والناس بين مستغل لها في الطاعات، وبين منشغل في الشهوات والملذات. وها قد أقبل علينا شهر رمضان، وما فيه من الأجور والحسنات والخير والبركات. ولقد أمرنا الله تعالى بالمسارعة إلى الخيرات، والمسابقة إلى الطاعات، لنكون من أهل جنة عرضها الأرض والسماوات. قال تعالى: وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين. والمسارعة إلى المغفرة والجنة تكون ببذل الإحسان وتقوى الرحمن. سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله، ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء، والله ذو الفضل العظيم. ولذلك أثنى الله على أهل المسابقة والمسارعة إلى الخيرات، وجعل منزلتهم في أعالي الجنات، فقال: السابقون السابقون أولئك المقربون في جنات النعيم، ثلة من الأولين وقليل من الآخرين. فأعدوا العدة للاجتهاد، فالصبر على الطاعة من أعظم أبواب الجهاد. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His forgiveness. And we ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to shower His peace and blessings upon the Messenger Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and upon his family and companions and all those who hold firm upon the Sunnah until Yawm Al-Qiyamah. All those whom Allah misguides, none can guide. And all those whom Allah guides, none can misguide. and I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship in truth but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is the slave and messenger of Allah. And the most evil of affairs are the innovations, and every innovation is a misguidance, and every misguidance is in the hellfire. Servants of Allah, days pass us, months go by, years go by, and the people are of two kinds. Between one who makes the most of them by performing righteous actions, and the one who is taken by his desires and lost time. Now upon us, my brothers and sisters, is the most blessed month of Ramadan. With it comes the good deeds, the righteousness, and the blessings from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has commanded us with fulfilling righteous actions and being quick in doing so, and so that we may be from the dwellers of paradise, that which is as wide as the heavens and the earth. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, and march forth in the way which leads to the forgiveness of your Lord, and for paradise as wide as the heavens and the earth, prepared for al-muttaqoon. And march forth here in this ayah is by being righteous and fearing Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Allah says, race one another in hastening towards forgiveness from your Lord and towards paradise, the width whereof, which is as the heavens and the earth, prepared for those who believe in Allah and His messengers. That is the grace of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, which He bestows on whom He pleases. And Allah is the owner of great bounty. For this reason, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has praised those who race towards righteousness, and He has made their place in the highest places in paradise. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, and those foremost will be foremost in paradise. These will be those nearest to Allah in the gardens of delight. A multitude, a great number of those will be from the first generations who embraced Islam, and a few of those will be from the latter times. So prepare yourselves, my brothers and sisters, and know that from the greatest forms of jihad is to be patient upon performing righteous actions. Ibadallah, قد بين نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم أهمية الوقت لأهل الإيمان وحث على استغلاله واغتنامه في طاعة الرحمن وحذر من التفريط فيه وتضييعه بالعصيان. فعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لرجل وهو يعظه اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس: شبابك قبل هرمك، وصحتك قبل سقمك، وغناك قبل فقرك، وفراغك قبل شغلك، وحياتك قبل موتك. وأخبر أن العباد مسؤولون أمام الله تعالى عما أفنوا فيه أعمارهم وقضوا فيه أوقاتهم، فكيف إذا كان وقتا فاضلا وزمنا شريفا كرمضان. فعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: لا تزال قدم ابن آدم يوم القيامة من عند ربه حتى يسأل عن خمس: عن عمره فيما أفناه، وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه، وماله من أين اكتسبه وفيما أنفقه، وماذا عمل فيما علم. Servants of Allah, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has made clear and apparent to the believing Muslims, to the believers, the importance and significance of time. He made evident the need to spend it in the obedience of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and not in spending it whilst falling into sin and disobedience. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhum mentions that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take advantage of five before five. Your youth before your old age. Your health before your illness. Your riches before your poverty. Your free time before your work. And your life before your death. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminded us that we will be questioned on the day of resurrection. The way and the manner in which we conducted our lives, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the son of Adam will not be dismissed from their Lord on the day of resurrection until he has been questioned about five. His life and how he spent it. His youth and how he used it. His wealth and how he earned it and how he disposed of it. And how he acted upon what he acquired of knowledge. عباد الله لا شك أن قلوب المسلمين فرحة ومستبشرة بمقدم شهر رمضان وحق لنا أن نفرح وحق لنا أن نفرح به ونستبشره فقد أعد الله فيه من الفضل والأجور ما ليس في غيره من الشهور فهو شهر الصيام الذي يمثل ركنا من أركان الإسلام فمن صامه إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه هو شهر القيام فمن قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه فيه ليلة خير من ألف شهر هي ليلة القدر التي أنزل فيه القرآن فيها القرآن من قامها إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه هو شهر القرآن فيه أنزل وفيه يشرع للمسلم أن يجتهد في قراءته وتلاوته وتدبره ما لا يجتهد في غيره هو شهر مبارك فرض الله عليكم صيامه تفتح فيه أبواب السماء وتغلق فيه أبواب الجحيم وتغل فيه مردة الشياطين لله فيه ليلة خير من ألف شهر من حرم خيرها فقد حرم. My brothers and sisters, there is no doubt that the hearts are excited and overwhelmed with joy due to the approach of Ramadan. Because Allah has bestowed within this period a great reward which one cannot attain outside of this period. Within it is the fasting, which fulfills one of the five pillars of Islam, that which our very religion is built upon. It has within it the fasting. Whomever fasts with iman and hope for the reward from Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive that person's previous sins. It has within it the night prayer, the tarawih prayer. Whoever prays it with iman and hoping for the reward from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive that person's previous sins. It has within it the night of al-qadr, laylatul qadr. It is better than 1,000 months. Whomever prays within that night with iman and the hope of the reward from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, all his or hers previous sins will be forgiven. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this month was the most diligent in the recitation of the Quran. And he was the most diligent in Ramadan. It is upon us, brothers and sisters, to stick to recitation of the Quran as much as we can within this beloved and blessed month. In a hadith, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu mentioned that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ramadan has come to you, a blessed month. Allah has made it obligatory upon you to fast in it. During this month, the gates of heaven are open, the gates of hellfire are closed, and the evil devils are chained. To Allah belongs a night in it, which is better than 1,000 months. Whoever is prevented from its good, then he has been deprived. إن شهرا بهذه المثابة وموسما بهذا القدر حري بأن نستعد له أحسن استعداد ومن خير ما يستعد به المسلم لهذا الشهر بتعلم أحكام الصيام والقيام والتفقه فيها وكذا تعلم أحكام الاعتكاف والاعتمار لمن أراد شيئا منهما في هذا الشهر واحرص على السؤال عما يشكل عليك من أحكام الصيام فإن العبادة لا ينفع بها صاحبها إلا إذا كانت خالصة لوجه الله وكانت موافقة لهدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Servants of Allah, a month with such virtue deserves our complete devotion and dedication. And a great form of dedication of a Muslim is to give from their time to the understandings of the rulings of this month, from fasting and from the night prayers. And to be open to asking questions from the people to the people of knowledge if you do not know. And know, my brothers and sisters, that a servant of Allah will not be benefited by way of his worship unless it is sincere for the sake of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and upon the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله تعالى لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، عباد الله، دعا جبريل عليه السلام وأمن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على من أدركه هذا الشهر ولم يغفر له، فيا أيها المقصرون ويا أيها المذنبون وكلنا أهل تقصير وذنوب، اجعلوا هذا الشهر باب خير لكم في عودتكم إلى ربكم والتخلص من جميع الذنوب والآثام، فالسعيد من حاسب نفسه وتاب قبل أن يقبل على الله يوم الحساب. عباد الله، السعيد من اغتنم أيامه ولياليه بالطاعات واجتهد في إحسان الصيام والقيام وصان جوارحه عن الخطايا والآثام ورجع إلى ربه ذي الجلال والإكرام، ويا حسرة المفرطين ويا ندامتهم يوم الدين. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His forgiveness. Brothers and sisters, Jibreel alayhi salam, he made dua against the one who meets the month of Ramadan and does not have his sins forgiven. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ameen. So, my brothers and sisters, whom are falling short in matters of the deen, my brothers and sisters, who are committing sin, and every single one of us falls short and commits sin, return to Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Return to Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, seeking His forgiveness, seeking His repentance, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may allow us to enter into this month forgiven from our sins. And know, my brothers and sisters, that if one rids himself from the sins that he has held before Ramadan enters, then he enters this blessed month in a state much better than that which he was in. عباد الله واعلموا أنه لا يصوم المسلمون إلا إذا ثبت دخول الشهر بأحد طريقين لا ثالث لهما وهما رؤية هلال رمضان فإن لم يرى فبإتمام شعبان 30 يوما ولا عبرة بالحساب الفلكي. Servants of Allah, a very important and serious matter. Know that the Muslims, we do not begin fasting the month of Ramadan except by way of two situations. Not a third, not a fourth. The first being if the crescent moon of Ramadan is sighted. Second, if it is not sighted, then we continue the month of Sha'ban as 30 days. And there is no consideration given to astrological calculations made by many Muslims in order to determine the entrance of the month of Ramadan. They may do so sometimes days, if not weeks, prior to its time. This is not accepted, and it is a falsely practiced manner in which people calculate the month of Ramadan and its entrance. This opinion is rejected because this is considered playing with the religion of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Such opinions must not be adopted by the majority of the Muslims. We do not accept such opinions, and we return our legislation to what Allah and His Messenger have legislated for us. Brothers and sisters, today is the 29th of Sha'ban. If our neighboring Muslim countries tell us they have sighted the moon after their local Maghrib time, then inshallah, the first day of Ramadan will be tomorrow. If they have not sighted the moon, then the first day of Ramadan inshallah will be Sunday. Taraweeh prayer in this masjid will begin on Saturday at 9 p.m. Isha, then Taraweeh. And from Sunday on, from Saturday at 9 p.m. From Sunday onwards, it will be from 8 p.m. because it will be daylight savings time. And finally, Jum'ah from next week will be from 12:30. Barakallahu feekum. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في ديننا ودنيانا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا. اللهم تب علينا وارحمنا. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى، وإنا نعوذ بك من عذاب في النار وعذاب في القبر. وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد.